Once you have names defined on your worksheet, you can then use them in a formula. For instance, in the previous movie, we set up the names of sales as well as tax. And let's go ahead and add these two together to give us the total sales. So we'll come down here to B18, and to use names in a formula, you simply start your formula off with an equal sign and then select the cell that has been named. So here I'll select E13, which is sales. Then I want to add that to the total tax. And notice in my formula bar, it reflects sales plus tax, which makes a lot more sense in understanding what a formula is computing. So I'll go ahead and enter that by pressing my Enter key, and here is my total number. Now let's go ahead and apply this to our project. So open up or access your sales monthly workbook, or if you'd like to start with a file that reflects the development of the class up to this point, go ahead and open up 0812 start file. So I'll go ahead and open up this sales monthly workbook. And if you'll scroll down to the bottom, you'll see that on cells D38, we applied the name of total unit cost. And over here on F38, we have total sales. So let's do the following. Let's go ahead and figure out what our profit was for this week. So let's come down here to A44 and set your cursor, and let's create a text label for our weekly profit. Go ahead and enter that. This is just a text label, and then select B44, and we'll create our formula using names that will calculate what our weekly profit was for this week. So come up here to your formula bar, set your cursor and type an equal sign, and then come over here and click on F38 to select our total sales, and then we subtract our unit cost, our total unit cost here in D38. So go ahead and select that, press enter, and notice that our profit for this week is $132.75. Let's go ahead and format that as a number format. So select your home tab of your ribbon, and in the number group, click the dollar or accounting number format command and create a dollar format for that. Go ahead and save your workbook, and let's move on to the next movie.